Welcome to today's Grow It Green. We're at Friz Home Gardens in Bedford. I'm joined by Margaret Hagen from UNH Cooperative Extension. And Margaret, before we get to today's subject, I just want to take a moment and give everybody a little bit of a treat here and show them this beautiful bougainvillea. The color's just spectacular. And I wish everyone could smell the scent here the greenhouse as well.
Yeah, it makes spring seem like it's not quite so far away.
All right, on to the subject of today's show, and that's something that's commonly known as the flowering maple.
Right, and in New Hampshire, it's either a houseplant in your home during the winter, and you can take it and plant it in a container outside on your deck for the summer. They grow really fast, and in good light outside, it doesn't take them all that long to get to be 3 feet, 4 feet tall.
Okay. Now here we can see the one you have in your hand too. It tends to droop over the container, right?
So these don't have very strong stems, and if you don't keep pruning them back to make the stem get thicker, then you can have them in a hanging basket. And you can see this one that's more tree-like has been pruned back pretty hard and slowly but surely trained to be more of a tree form.
And you can see also the beautiful colors they come in as well.
One of the things I really like is the variegated foliage on this yellow one.
Okay, and you have the red behind you.
There's red, there's peach right here, and it comes also in pink.
Are these difficult flowers to take care of?
Not particularly. The only thing that they like is a fairly warm temperature in your home. So if your home is like below 60 degrees, you might want to wait and buy it in the spring when you can put it on your deck. They do like bright light. They do like a fairly evenly moist soil. So if you're one of those people who forgets to water your plants until 3 weeks late,
probably not a good choice.
Probably not a good choice for you. But they bloom all year long.
Oh, they do. Okay. But you mentioned now they're hardy to about zone 9 or 10, but you need to have in your house, if you're thinking of keeping them year-round, what, about 70 degrees, or can you get a little wet?
65 to 70, but if your home is in the high 50s, probably not a good idea.
And there might have been a lot of homes like that.
This year especially.
So if I want some more information on these, what can I do?
You can go to the information line and call, or you can go to www.extension.unh.edu, and there'll be some information posted for you there.
Okay, that's a mouthful, and that's it for today's Grow It Green. Back to you in the studio.